Hello, everyone. Welcome to Vanished Chicagoland Stories, the podcast. I'm your host, Pete Costanis. This is episode 92, season 4. Today's date is December 26, 2021. And thank you for joining me on the day after Christmas. I hope everyone had a wonderful holiday. I certainly did. I will go into that in a little bit. And I will talk about two things on this podcast episode. I will talk about Dr. Lester Fisher, who just passed away recently, and also celebrating Ned Locke, who played Ringmaster Ned on Bozo Circus. He celebrates his birthday on Christmas Day. I will talk a little bit about him. First, we will go into a commercial break. And this program is brought to you by Marshmallow Fluff. And here is a commercial from the 1960s. Enjoy, everybody. We'll be right back. Thank you.
Oh, you need fluff, fluff, fluff to make a fluffer nutter. Marshmallow fluff and lots of peanut butter. First you spread, spread, spread your bread with peanut butter and marshmallow fluff and have a fluffer nutter. When you enjoy, joy, joy your fluff and peanut butter, you're glad you have enough for another fluffer.
Okay, everyone, I am back. I hope you enjoyed that commercial for Marshmallow Fluff. Let me give you a teeny tiny history of this product. I love the stuff. It's delicious. They called it either Marshmallow Fluff, Marshmallow Stuff, Marshmallow Spread, or Marshmallow Paste. And it's like it's a confectionery spread made of marshmallows. This is famous for making the classic sandwich, Fluffernutter sandwich. And actually, it's a New England tradition. I don't see people or even heard it. People eat it today, but it was very popular all throughout the years in the old days. And it debuted in 1918 in Massachusetts. And from what I heard, it was the company is in Lynn, Massachusetts, and I have relatives living there. And when my mother came to America in the 60s, she noticed that one of her neighbors had a jar of this. She'd never seen this before, you know, and it reminded her of this is a dessert called vanilla, vanilla, they call it like that. And it's like a scoop of vanilla, and you put it in a glass of water and you eat it. I love that stuff. It's good. That's what it reminds of her and me. I started eating the sandwich later on in life. I love it. You could put it on peanut butter and call it a fluffernutter sandwich, it's very sweet, very sticky. Oh, it really is. Oh, but it's good. It really is good. Okay. Thank you for joining me today. I hope everyone had a wonderful Christmas. I sure did. This is my first Christmas celebrating cancer-free. Thank you, God. With my family, my mom made a wonderful lunch and dinner. She made the pastizo, Greek lasagna. Always, I will. I took a photo of that. It's posted on Facebook. Also, for dinner we had leg of lamb, the potatoes, a salad. You know, and she made homemade bread, which I posted on my Facebook page, on my Facebook profile. Excuse me, not my page. And thank you for the comments. And my mom is 86 years old, and she's still doing this. She loves doing it. She gets, but I try to enjoy what she can because she does this out of love for our family. And I am very blessed, you know, for everything. And it's a beautiful Christmas. It really was. I enjoyed it. Okay. Today I will talk about my memories of Dr. Lester Fisher and celebrating Ned Locke's birthday, who was Ringmaster Ned on Bozo Circus. He turned 100. No, I'm sorry, he did not. He was born on Christmas Day. Actually, he's 102 if he was alive. But Dr. Fisher, he passed away on December 22nd at the age of 100. And he is famous for for his appearances on the Ray Rayner Show. And he was a zoologist, well, first a veterinarian and a zoologist. And I'll tell you about a little history of him. Also, my memories of watching him on television. And let's see. He went to Iowa State University in 1943. He received his doctorate of veterinary medicine. He served in World War II in Europe, and he was a veterinarian for General George S. Patton. And he treated his bull terrier. His dog's name was Willie. That I never knew. You know, I found that out. And he began his career as a veterinarian in 1947. And he had his own private practice in Berwyn. I don't know where in Berwyn it was. You know, I didn't have time to do some research on that. But that's what people said, and that's what I've heard. And he had two nicknames. He was Chicago's Dr. Doolittle, based on the 1967 movie that starred Rex Harrison, and Mr. Chimps. So, and he had his own practice from 1947 to 1962. And then when, if you remember Marlon Perkins, who had his own TV show, Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom, they used to show that on Channel 5 on Sundays. I remember seeing that. He was the director of the Lincoln Park Zoo, but he left that job and moved to St. Louis. And Dr. Lester Fisher succeeded him, and he was the zoo's director. And he was there until he retired in 1992. And he also appeared in a few documentaries, called The Arctic Window in 1985, and Otto, Zoo Gorilla, and Zookeepers. And he appeared in a few shows, and we all remember him appearing on the Ray Rayner Show and Bozo Circus, and I'll get to that in a second. And, you know, he lived a long life. It was wonderful. You know, what a wonderful man he was. He seemed he was like a father figure, and very knowledgeable of explaining the species and the animals. And so my first memory of seeing him was, of course, on the Ray Rayner Show. I don't think he appeared in Garfield Goose. I don't think so. No. So one of the segments on Ray Rayner was called Ark in the Park. And I look forward to that. And then you can hear the theme song while they show the opening credit of that. And it was filmed at Lincoln Park Zoo. Ray Rayner was there. I posted a photo of that the other day, you know, with the WGN TV camera. And that was from 1971. And I'm sure there were a few bloopers when they did. You know, when it comes to animals, well, you know, you can imagine. And watching him and learning something, you know, from animals, was fascinating. I was thrilled. You know, I loved watching this man explain everything about the animal world. And Ray Rayner seemed very interested and intrigued about that, you know, and, you know, throwing his own sense of humor. You know. And that started in the 70s. And I don't know, I think until Ray Rayner's show went off the air in 1981. And then Dr. Fisher appeared on Bozo Circus, and it was called The Bozo Show. And I don't know how long he was there, probably during the 80s, not very long. I don't know if he continued after Bob Bell, who played Bozo, left. I don't know. I have no idea. So, but we all know the song that plays during, you know, at the beginning of the segment, Ark in the Park. And that song is called The Unicorn by the Irish Rovers. So now I'm going to play the song not the entire song, just what it was sung, just one lyric of that, of the television segment. So here is The Unicorn by the Irish Rovers. Enjoy, everybody. Thank you.
You'll see green alligators and long-necked geese, some humpty backcomers and some chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, you're never gonna see no unicorn.
Okay, everyone, I am back. I hope you enjoyed the song. That is memorable. Memorable. People can repeat the lyrics of The Unicorn. And I'll give you a little history of that song and the group. Okay. This song was recorded by the Irish Rovers. They're a group of Irish musicians that originated from Toronto, Canada. And they sang a lot of songs. Most famous is The Unicorn. They also sang The Drunken Sailor, Wasn't That a Party, The Orange and the Green, Whiskey on a Sunday, Lily the Pink, and The Black Velvet Band. So they're still performing, but they have new members. So they change. But originally it was the Millar Brothers. They're originally from Northern Ireland. And they probably came to Toronto. And, they got together with some other members, and the rest was history. And I never knew about this. I never knew about the group. I don't know who sang it when I first heard the song when I was a kid, when they played it on the Ray Raina show during the Ark in the Park segment. So the song, The Unicorn, let's see, I'll look it up. Let's see, yeah. All right. The Unicorn, it was written by Shel Silverstein, excuse me. You know, he was a writer, a poet, cartoonist, songwriter. The lyrics appeared as a poem in his book. It was called Where the Sidewalk Ends. And so the Irish Rovers sang it, but, you know, they didn't write the song. You know, so probably got credit for that. The song was released in 1962. And by then, the Irish Rovers, that song was released, but I don't know if the Irish Rovers I don't know if they recorded. They did not. The song was released in 1962, but the Irish Rovers recorded in 1968. And it zoomed up into popularity, and then based on the Billboard charts, and also in the United States and Canada, where they're from, and Ireland. Okay. And so, when you first heard that song, like I said before on the Ray Raina show, it's very catchy, and you can't get it out of your head. And I remember, while you're listening to the song, they showed different kinds of animals. I remember there was a giraffe, there was a camel, there was a chimpanzee. I think there was a seal in the water. I think you can find the video or the segment on YouTube if you can do a search on it. And you would see there's some couple episodes of the Ray Raina show. And if you can find the segment, it's there. So that's very interesting. I love the song. I really did. And as for Dr. Lester Fisher, when I heard when he passed away, it was so sad because he's like a part of my life, And WGN did an interview of him earlier this year. And I think Dean Richards from WGN interviewed him. And he was 100 years old. He lived in Hayward, Wisconsin. And, he was in a wheelchair, but his mind was like a steel trap. He remembered everything. Thank God for that. Oh, it was wonderful. And what a lovely interview it was. I watched it, and I watched it again recently. and he explained his duties and what he did at Lincoln Park Zoo. It's amazing and wonderful. I really did. And, you know, he turned 100 years old on February 24th. Amazing man. We will miss him. We really will. Okay. Next up, we go talk about Ned Locke. I talked about him on a previous episode on my podcast. So what better way to, because he was born on Christmas Day, I'll talk to him about again. You know, I will talk about his life and his memories. And I did some podcast episodes in September about the 60th anniversary of Bozo Circus. And it was a 4-part podcast episode. And you can still find them on any platform that podcast has. Just please subscribe to my podcast, and you could have they're on my YouTube channel under the same name, Vanish Chicagoland Stories. Just do a search, you will find it. And I went into more detail about Bozo Circus and my memories of that, and I enjoyed that very much. I also created a video, and it's also there on YouTube. Okay, and it's all over my social media accounts. All right, so right now I'll talk about Ned Locke. Actually, his real name was Norbert Locke. He was born December 25th, 1919. He was from Red Wing, Minnesota, and probably nearby Minneapolis. And he got into radio at the age of 9, and he performed in local theater in high school, and then he became a radio announcer in Des Moines, Iowa. Then he moved to Chicago by 1950, and he was on a program called Uncle Ned's Squadron. And and let's see, he replaced another children's show, a children's host. His name was Johnny Coons, and on his Noontime comic series. I'm going to talk about him in a future episode. That sounds interesting. In 1951. He was also a pilot, and he flew planes, and he commuted from Des Moines to Chicago. Well, he was a busy guy. Oh, my God. You know, also served as director of aeronautics in the state of Iowa for 7 years. Interesting. He also did other shows called Captain Hearts and His Pets, and was sponsored by Hearts Mountain. I think it was like, you know, a company that sold bird seed and all that. And he wrote a lot of shows on radio and television. Oh, my. What a versatile man. What a versatile man. Then he got hired in WGN in 1956, and he became the weather forecaster. Oh, pre-Tom Skilling. Interesting. I would have loved to see that. I would love to see Mr. Ned doing the weather. That would be fascinating. You know, I wish there was footage of that. Then he co-starred in a series called Lunchtime Little Theater. That was at noon every day. And I think there's a clip somewhere in YouTube. If you can do a search, you will find it. And also he wrote, produced, and starred another show called Paddle Boat. And I think it was Captain Ned, his name. I don't remember. Anyway, and Roy Brown was the puppeteer in the show, which, of course, he played Cookie the Cook on Bozo Circus. And then when they started doing Bozo Circus, and they hired Ned Locke to be Ringmaster Ned. And on the last episode of Paddle Boat, he got his ringmaster costume for the last episode. And then the rest was history. And he was famous for that role. And I loved him in that role. He was a wonderful man. He kept his cool at times, you know, with Bozo and the gang, because they were mischievous. And sometimes he lost his patience. You know, clowns, what do you expect? You know, so, and it was funny seeing that. And then and he was there until 1976. So he was there on the first show, which premiered September 11th, 1961. Yeah, and then, like I said before, he retired in that 76, and he moved to Kimberling City, Missouri. And he was the chief of police, he owned a real estate firm, and then he became the mayor. You know, and from what I heard, when he lived in Chicago, he lived in Wheaton, Illinois. And according to some comments on my Facebook page, they used to see this man. They used to see Mr. Ned walking around, going to the grocery store. One time he was at a liquor store. I don't know. That was a rumor, you know, but I don't think he was a drinker. I doubt that. Some people said that he had a temper behind the scenes, or maybe he did, maybe he did not. But some people say he wasn't fond of children, but I don't believe that. Because he had two kids, you know, and he had a lot of grandchildren, and he was married for a long time. And then he died in February 4th, 1992. He had liver cancer, which was a shame. But he did make appearances on the anniversaries of the show, the 25th and the 30th. I don't know if he filled in when Frazier Thomas took over. I don't think he did. I don't remember seeing that. But, and then so... So we'll see. So okay, everyone, I'll be right back for some more. Thank you. Okay, everyone, I am back. I'm sorry about the interruption. I had a visitor in my house. So I will end this program now. Thank you for joining me. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas. This is episode 92, season 4 of Van Chicagoland Stories. I'm your host, Pete Costanis, and I talked about Dr. Lester Fisher, and also talk about Ned Locke on his birthday, which falls on Christmas. I will do another episode in the coming days. I don't know what day. Probably next weekend. We'll see. I'll talk about New Year's Eve, about memories of celebrating in Chicago. So we will see. So right now, thank you for joining me. Have a wonderful holiday season, and bye-bye for now for me. And here's Ray Rayner saying bye-bye for now. Take care, everybody. So long.
We have to go. Bye-bye-bye.